Hey guys, Andrea Rene here for the Escapist. It is day three. We're wrapping up. I'm here with some friends. You guys know Ashley Esqueda. We've got Anthony from Smosh Games and Mari from Smosh Games. Thanks for joining us, guys.
Yeah, no problem.
So, did you have a good time at E3?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
My feet had a terrible time. They had
Can't
the worst
you tell
time
how
ever.
Terrible of a time I had.
I can see the non-enthusiasm on your face. I was like gaming crack for 3 days straight. It was like mainline and all the great games. It was awesome.
It's considered work, but you get to just play all day.
Yeah. It's pretty awesome, yeah. Indeed. So what did you see that you liked on the show floor?
One thing I was really surprised is this game called Cloudberry Kingdom.
Oh.
It's a platformer. It's kind of like it's really simple, but it has randomly generated platforming levels, and you could change the amount of obstacles, and it gets really deep, and I love platformers, so I was really pleasantly surprised with that.
Nice. I didn't check that one out, but I'll have to check it out now.
As far as games go, gosh, there was a lot of things in the Indiecade that piqued my attention,
yeah.
But seeing... Joust?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's
Johan Sebastian Joust.
Yeah.
I think it's like its third time here at Indiecade. Yeah, I played it a couple years ago. It's really, really fun.
It's just fun. Yeah, to finally kind of use the move. I personally haven't used the move before, and to have it so interactive with a big group like that is fun.
Watching
yeah, tens of people have used the move. Tens of people. I got to see, gameplay-wise, I got to play Transistor, which was like... gorgeous, super giant games. I mean, they always make. Bastion was so beautiful. The voiceover's really good. I loved playing it. I played the demo, but I took your advice and I went and saw The Witcher 3.
Oh, yes. Oh my gosh.
And
freaking out about The Witcher.
I may have, my mind was just like right out of my ears, and I was like, I need this game. Like, it was just so amazing.
I know. I was really bummed that they were like, yeah, we're kind of over a year away from really getting hands on or anything.
The worst when
that's when the tears flow.
They introduce things, they're like, a year or more.
My favorite thing of the show has been like, there are these like 20-foot high posters for things like Metal Gear Solid 5. And then you walk up and you're like, man, I want to cover Metal Gear Solid. And they're like, yeah, we're not talking about that this year. And I'm like,
I know, right?
But you have a 50-foot snake on the wall, and you've enticed me to your booth like a moth to the flame.
But see,
and now you're going to deny me.
The Witcher gives out puzzles so that you can work on your puzzle for a whole year.
Ties
puzzles.
You over.
Jigsaw puzzles.
Just jigsaw puzzles.
So by the time you complete it, you can go out and buy the game.
Totally, yeah. It's like, it reminds me of like a Hellraiser puzzle box. Like,
Well, one of the cool things... that I saw, sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off My bad.
We gotta keep this short.
Yes, fast. Mad Max.
I was
really, really impressed with what I saw. The teaser trailer that they showed at the press conference was like just like such a small snippet. I was like, I have to see more.
So is it a game based off the movie?
It is. It's an open world car combat RPG that looks absolutely amazing.
Anything like Twisted Metal? I haven't seen it.
No, I think it's more, I would say it's more like Rage. Did you ever play that game?
Okay, yes, no. I'll buy that.
Yeah,
that's about right.
It's pretty cool. So you can, you have customizable cars, and like upgrading your car is like a big part of the progression system. And there's like these, you know, you're in the wasteland, you're Max, you have these crazy ass weapons. There's a really big emphasis on melee combat. But I thought it looked really cool. But there was a lot of things that I missed this year.
Yeah.
Did you guys, like, what was the one thing that you were like, damn it, I missed it?
Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare. I guess they were allowing you to play behind closed doors.
Well, I didn't get hands-on with the game, but they showed like a full match, four-player co-op multiplayer match. So I saw it and it was really awesome.
I really want to know.
It looks really, really good. And I told the dev team, I was like, I was so surprised that these guys were able to keep this completely under wraps. Like, no leaks.
Yeah.
Nobody knew it was coming. It's going to be really awesome. And you're going to be able to play as the zombies in multiplayer.
Oh, that's my life dream. It's been coming true. I can't wait. It's going to be so amazing. I love it. I didn't get to see, there's just always a line, Watch Dogs. I just really want to see all the stuff they have with like mobile and the tablets, and you can like call for help and someone's on their phone or their tablet and they can like help you out. Like, I totally dig that. I love that like interconnectivity between devices. I think it's amazing. But I didn't see it. I was so bummed.
Well, that was a really big thing on the show floor this year. It was like almost everybody was showing some kind of tablet integration with their game. So
Smart Glass, huge deal with Xbox One. This is gonna be a big thing. So mm-hmm.
What about you, Mari?
I would have liked to have played through the story mode for Assassin's Creed.
Oh,
Black
yeah.
They were only showing multiplayer, right?
Right.
Yes. I heard that judges got to go hands-on with AZ4, but maybe next year for us. We'll
we'll see. Send your email to e3judges@e3expo.com.
Is that an actual email address?
I don't know. If it is, I'm sorry. Like, whoever's getting that email, I'm so sorry. If it's real, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, the one thing I was bummed that I missed was Quantum Break, the exclusive coming to Xbox One that looks really cool. I'll have to...
Frozen in time, grabbing ladies out of time. That was all I saw.
That looked awesome.
No, it looks so amazing.
I'm gonna have to go to the Escapist magazine site and read our coverage on it. Somebody else got to go see it.
Yeah, there is a lot. We do have coverage of that, so make sure you go check it out on the Escapist.
Absolutely, and there's lots of coverage over on Smosh Games too. You guys shot a bunch of stuff while you were here. So please make sure to go check out all of our videos. We'll put all the links down in the description below for you guys. So that's it for us for E3. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next year. Or next week, you know.
Next year. We're never coming back.